Hey, Joe here. In today's video, we're going to show how I put together my double pumper E85 compatible fuel pump setup for my Eclipse. It took me a while to put this video together as I had to keep ordering new parts, kind of a trial and error thing to get the right parts that would do the job. So follow along, I'll show you what I did. This is what the pump assembly looks like stock. The pump assembly and fuel level sending unit are separate in this car, allowing me to modify the pump assembly without disturbing the sender. First, I disconnected the pump connector and power terminals. I'll need to drill the bulkhead wiring connectors out. Removing the terminals left a couple large holes that I'll weld closed before making new holes for my pump wiring. Next, I removed the hose clamps and OEM pump from the assembly. After the pump was removed, I had to remove the factory metal fuel line from the assembly. Then I cleaned things up a bit. I brought the assembly over to my friend Nick to have the wiring holes welded up. Next, I drilled the assembly to fit the AN8 bulkhead fitting.
I cleaned up the rough edges with a file. I installed the AN8 bulkhead fitting with Teflon washers. This is the original Y fitting I tried to use, but it didn't fit through the tank opening. I had to order the Speed Flow Y from Australia. I used aluminum AN wrenches to tighten these. Next, I installed the fuel line that was supplied with my pump onto the 90-degree AN6 to barbed fittings. I installed the 90-degree fittings on the AN6Y. This is the AEM 50-1200 320 liter per hour E85 pump I'll be using. Here, I measured up and trimmed the hose to length. Next, I put the hose clamps on the hose and pushed the pump onto the hose. I had to trim the stop for the OEM pump off. Then I installed the pumps with the 90-degree fittings to the assembly. And tightened the clamps. I removed the pumps and installed the rubber buffer sleeves. After that, I stabilized the pumps on the assembly with a couple 3-inch stainless hose clamps. I had to drill and file some holes for the wiring. I installed some 1/4-inch grommets in these holes. After installing the fuel socks that came with the pumps, I test fit the pump assembly in the tank.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you next time.